Hello. Oh no. Coming to you live once again from the wind tunnel. As we're going to do some more Breath of Fire. I wonder if the translator put that in, or if that was always how it was set up. Oh, there's actually talons inside his mind. Isn't that clever? Okay. Him. Goes a lot faster when you have frame skip too. You just hold down the plus key and go blah 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 blah, 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 boom, 12,000 experience. 300 Zenny. Okay. You just stay for free or what? It says in. I cannot interact with the beds though. I have to talk to this guy or something. Any ammonias? Yes, I do. I got some stuff I can sell too. I'll just do that. Double whip. Does a sparrow get two turns with the double whip? I like how most of the stuff they sell is worse than the stuff you probably have. There's a few decent items though, so. Rand learned Quake. I've never actually played Daikatana, but from all that I've seen and heard of it, I don't really want to. And I hear the Nintendo 64 version is even worse. Well, actually, that's not entirely true. I played the Game Boy Color version, which basically completely reworks it into kind of a Zelda knockoff. It's okay, I guess, but really nothing too spectacular. RPGs usually. So you're in some obscure piece of crap on Quest 64. No one ever plays. dragon brood. Chronicled in the first game, where Ryu's clan gets killed off by the Dark Dragon clan at the behest of the goddess Tyr, who is very, very evil. She also returns in 3 as the main villain, I believe. Okay. Well, I do have the power to turn into a dragon. Does that count? Even if it's for like 5 seconds, just to do one attack. And there's that guy locked up. Man. Hi, bear. And yeah, this is supposed to be the same world as the previous game, and it looks completely different. I don't really get it. Fire spice, shaved ice, and thunder rod. Not yet. Who's this guy? Have I found the Tower of Memories yet? Should be able to see it from the lake to the west. Alright. Front of the gate. Gandalf, okay. This is probably a good, pretty good place to, level up my characters, actually. Oh, I've got pretty much everyone I care to use right now, so. And they'd only switch out a Sparrow, otherwise you can't get back out. Alright. Deal with you later. Okay. West of the lake. You'll see the first town. I get it, the tower is the first town, because there's only supposed to be 2 towns. Do see the walls far away from you, but not the ones close to you. There's Slims McKenzie throwing lightning at me. Rambo reached level 25. How do I get over there? I just have to pay him to get in? I might. I played Joker Link to the Past, I know how this works. Miso stew. It's a shield. I'll give it to my party healer. But he needs much help for HP, but it's good to keep him alive so he can heal other people, I think. Also, I found out something kind of odd about shaman fusions. If your character drops to critical HP, it'll unfuse them, but if they just get killed, it won't, so... I don't know why that's the case. But, it's a little strange. I don't remember anything. I also don't remember anything. Treasure chest remembers everything. He won't leave me alone. Okay. Cat died. Lynn died, rather. Keep calling her Cat. So that was her name in the original translation. Increases wisdom. Okay. Good enough. Let's go. Here he is. Detrimental to our god's ambitions. he erased all the villagers' memories. It all makes sense now. Well, it is fun when the villains just come clean. Apparently. Fire dragon, not that it matters. And let's boost Cat's Lynn's defense, because that seems to be her lowest point. Oh, and he makes you forget spells, that's right. Like, the most recent spell you've cast, you won't be able to use for the rest of the fight. Is Alzheimer. Well, of course it is. That cat can't cast any spells yet. She gets all these really good attack spells, but she doesn't get nearly enough AP to cast them until like the end of the game. You have the Dark Shaman fused to her, and she can get a pretty substantial AP boost. He's even attacked me once. It's like the last fight of Xenosaga 2, where he just taunts you over and over again. I think he only attacked me once that entire fight.
I mean, it makes sense from a storyline point, but, well, I won't give it away. But, yeah. Always kind of silly when the last fight in an RPG is so anticlimactic. I'm just gonna hit you with Omni Slash and that's it. Although I honestly kind of liked that scene, because, you finally get your revenge on Sephiroth, I guess.
Close the book on him once and for all, or at least until they make another shitty CGI movie.
At
Advent Children was not very good. I mean, the combat scenes were amusing, but everything else about it was just... And honestly, they could have just subbed in any characters they wanted and just made a new movie, so they didn't have to tarnish Final Fantasy VII's image, I think. Not that it needs much help with that, with all the stupid fanboys they have, but... You know what I mean. Don't indulge them. Because I've said it before, but Final Fantasy VII was a game I liked when it was new, but because everyone and their mother has copied elements from it and just kind of run it into the ground, I don't think it's aged very well. Plus, it still has a lot of, you know, outdated and silly things about it that don't make it that appealing these days. Which is kind of why I'm looking forward to the remake. As long as they don't fuck it up, of course. As Squares have to do. Anyway... Okay. All right, let's get as much information as we can out of him. So we give their lives to fight. Okay. Gotta go south to the people of Gate, presumably. Yeah. The Dragon Warrior. That would be Ryu from the first game. First Breath of Fire is still my favorite. Maybe I'll stream that one sometime. What's down here? We have to head south. Okay. We can't get through here yet. Heaven Tower is where we have to go. It's another one of those instances of an invisible plot flag being triggered. So, yeah, I can't really sequence break it. Let's see, it's in the ocean west of Gate. So down this way. Been to yet. Some other place I haven't been to yet. Some other place I haven't been to yet. Sky Tower is in the ocean west of Gate, so... Oh. I'm completely in the wrong place. Alright. I think this is all kind of endgame stuff over here. Okay. Doodly doodly doo. I suppose I can just teleport to Gate, huh? Probably not, but I can teleport to, somewhere relatively close, I think. Or just walk over there. Since it's pretty close. dot in the middle of the ocean that I need to go to. There it is. Hi, fishmen. This is sort of taking on a Phantasy Star vibe here with all the technological centers that control tectonic plates and whatnot. Go in. What? Am I flying down there like on the Klinger Winger unicycle from Battletoads? What do you mean? Let's get the. I can fix that. One moment. There we go. Armory. I'm gonna set up shop in this little air pocket. Middle of a restricted area. Circuits for everybody. Okay. I'll go the other way. Get that chest. Doodly doo 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 doo. Dead mollusks. 1,000 zenny. I think so, yeah. Since we're underwater and we drown. Although amusingly exerting yourself underwater by fighting doesn't make it go down any faster. Give me a little bit more cash here. That ought to be enough. And one more. Dahlias. Guess a Spera gets some pretty good support spells, but you're still probably not going to want to use them that much. Support spells aren't really that useful in this game, unfortunately. Alright. speed maze from Ninja Turtles on the NES. Except it doesn't electrocute you. Oh shit! These guys are powerful. Why am I on auto battle? This is not where I want to be. Demon sword, which is substantially more powerful than my current weapon, so let's just use it. Unless it causes me permanent, like, confusion status or some shit. What? I'd better hurry. Up the stairs. Thank you. Sky Tower. There's nowhere to climb up, though. Unless I missed something. Battletoads! flooded, but the rest of the floor is? That doesn't make any sense. Guts pill. Those items from Earthbound I never use. No, no. Increases will. Give it to Lynn. Let's see. Strider, the room with the gravity. The thing that rotates you around the room and then throws you all over the place. That's what this is. There we go. Ice shield. Ice armor. Horse dagger. Okay. So like the boomerang from the first game where it can hit multiple times or hit all enemies. I guess not. Maybe it's for Sten, actually. Una. That is the Wind Sage, I believe. So we confuse her with Nina. Oh, Jesus. Apparently Mighty Number 9 is not doing too well in reviews. Pretty disappointing, because we thought the guy who produced several of the Mega Man games could pull it off, but he got into a really bad habit. A lot of game developers do, it seems. They just start promising things that they're gonna do, and then, you know, before their first game is even out, and then it all just kind of falls apart, because they're doing too many things at once, not putting focus on making the game good. I mean, I'll reserve judgment on it until I play it myself, but, from all I've seen and heard, my birthday gift from Keiji Inafune this year is a big box of disappointment. Thanks, Keiji. Thank you. so I can leave now. I can't instantly escape the dungeon now, unfortunately. So I'll just walk back out. It's always a shame. I promise something great and it ends up being average at best, you know? I mean, that's sort of what happened with this game, but it's still a pretty creative game in a lot of ways, I think. It's just not very polished, so, but it's still a fan favorite, so maybe I'm just talking out of my ass. I would like to see a remake of this game that has a lot of the original ideas polished up and done well, but I don't know if that's ever going to happen with the way Capcom is now. Anyhow, I should go switch in Nina so I can power her up. Maybe use her with the Wind Sage to get her a little bit of a boost. She only has one transformed form, but that should at least give her a stat upgrade. This isn't her ultimate form, but it'll give her a substantial upgrade nevertheless. That gives her a new color palette.
which is kind of neat.
Get Rand the other one, because Cat rejects everything except the Dark Shaman. So. Blake can use it in conjunction with another one, but the Dark Shaman has to be there for her to get any benefit whatsoever, so.
Reach.
Dragon God can switch Nina and Lin. How's that? That'll work. It's the village of the armadillos. Several hours at least. Get the hell out of my home, you beatnik. Alright. The hell are you? Wow. Okay. The trick here is, in order to get the Earth Shaman, you have to clear everything without using offensive magic, because that'll damage the Earth or whatever. Donate at the church 20 times. Shouldn't really even need to use offensive magic anyway, because they don't fight back. Thank you. 1,000 gold to the shrine. As long as you do what she tells you. Earth Temple. Okay. It's to the west of this town, so we'll go there, I guess. Is that it? Up on the hill. Might be. Enemies I've already fought. Oh, name of Jesus. Enough already. Token. I still don't know what those are for. Okay. As long as you don't try to cook me and eat me again. Beds of nails. Buried in the ground, apparently. There are monks of the S&M order. Sure. Okay. Hi. Nothing fishy about this at all. I think that was the original translation on the Super Nintendo. Because, it was very lackluster in a lot of ways. Like, to the point where the story just devolves into complete nonsense by the end. Beat up Ray too. Church of St. Eva is obviously corrupt, but, can't shake the feeling they're trying to say something, you know? Maybe that's why this game is so popular. Atheists. Of course, what they don't realize is by buying this, they're putting money into the pockets of the conservatives who run Capcom and Nintendo, so. Joke's on them, I guess. Music again. Hmm. You can get an extra spell here that halves the HP of all enemies, but apparently it's pretty hard to do. Let's give it a try, I guess. I suppose this game isn't completely anti-religion because Eva's a false god, whereas the dragon god seems to be on the level. So, yay tribalism, I guess. Hell with it. I hate music puzzles. Although I guess it's not as bad as Chrono Cross's, since that one is actually required to complete the game and get the good ending. And the game pretty much gives you no clues to that fact until you've already completed the dungeon where it is and you can't go back. So odds are you're just going to have to check a guide anyway. And then there was Yoshi's Speedway or whatever in Super Mario RPG. I had to push buttons in time with the music. Cryosphinx? I don't remember that. I just remember going on the beach and then Marl and Luca are like, yo, you have to do this, and I'm like, okay, you should have told me that before I went in the dungeon so I could figure out what it is. So I had to go on the internet and look up a walkthrough. And even then, I still could never get it right, because he would always cast the wrong spell and mess it all up. Ah. Was that the one you get the prism glasses from? I don't remember. Oh yeah, it was. And then the spell order he does it in is the clue you need. But it doesn't tell you that specifically, so you kind of have to know it ahead of time anyways. I don't know what I was doing wrong, because I played it back in, like, 2000 when it came out, and I decided I didn't really like it, so I sold it not long thereafter. Okay, what do I need to go back to Township. I do. Yeah. I guess it does make sense, but it's not really something you'd think of to talk to your party member, I think, because, generally there wasn't a lot of inter-party dialogue in RPGs in this era. To India. Let's go to India then. I get to do. Water and wind. Thank you. There's gonna be somewhere I can land on there. Maybe I can go around. Mina and Nina. I have pink wings now. There's a rumor going around that they're not giving out the Mighty No. 9 backer codes tomorrow, so, off, dude. yeah, people will be screaming if that happens, I bet. Concept might just get sued out of existence if that happens. Not that they're in good standing with most gamers at the moment anyways, but that would be the final nail. This isn't a scummy thing to do at all. Quickening levels of cartoonishly evil. Highlander 2, if you haven't seen it, is just one of those really bad movies that's kind of magical in how bad it is. I mean, they tried to fix it with the special edition, but, there was really no saving that film. And the special edition is a lot better, but... yeah. Although I've heard Highlander Source. The Source is actually way worse than that, but, I don't really care enough to track it down and find out, because I'm not the biggest Highlander fan. But it basically just turns the whole thing into a parody of itself. So, yeah. It's the same enemies we've seen already. A firebrand from Ghosts and Goblins. It looked like him. Okay. Shit.
here. Storm Ring. Is that a weapon for Nina? It sure is. Summon the Reaper. Don't fear the Reaper. Just summon him. Shipping the devil down here. Is that why we're so opposed to Eva? Dungeon was gonna be a pain if you didn't have any healing items, so. They planned accordingly.
Not that I didn't need too much help with that. I do not. Half-Life with a Guitar Hero controller. Joel, you crazy motherfucker. Status, and now I've lost my fusion. Great. Annoying. Leave this place. Okay. Got a job to do. I can't run away as I can. Probably a better plan with just Nina. That's the trade-off, huh? Oh, fuck. Oh, golly gosh. Okay. At least it doesn't completely fail you for it, so. Yeah. Apparently you don't even need to actually talk to the statues to get through, so we'll just skip ahead. I do want to get that chest, though. I have initiative, so I'm gonna run. Get away. Fuck. One enemy can deck you. It doesn't cost you all your money, at least. Just let me get the chests, and then we'll go on out.
That one on the other side, is that a good item too?
Guess we'll find out. This whole thing is just pure trial and error, it looks like. Yeah.
Who are you? Okay.
Okay, apparently that rumor was false, and Mighty Number 9 is in fact sending out codes. That's good. Like I said, if they stiff people on their codes, they'd have a lot more to worry about than just making it not so good game. I dare say they'd probably get sued into oblivion, in fact. Alright, well, at least the boss is easy. I got the winged seal. Oh, look, it's Breath of Fire 1, Nina. Nina the first. You put Nina on point, for fuck's sake. Let's put the weakest character up front. Number one rule, always put wizards in the back. Because they take one solid hit and they go down. Sacrifice herself and become the bird.
Hmm.
actually. What's Mina doing? She stole the seal. With it. Obviously still alive in some form, despite the... as indicated by that previous dialogue. So that was kind of a strange thing. Anyhow... now we can get to gate. Which is somewhere. Hmm.